them all, old time cowboys, and listen to my song. Please do not grow weary, I'll not detain you long. Concerning some wild cowboy who did agree to go and spend the summer pleasant on the trail of the buffalo. Well, I found myself in Griffin in the spring of 83, and a well-known famous drover I come a-walking up to me, saying, "How do you do, young feller, and how'd you like to go and spend the summer pleasant on the trail of the buffalo?" Well, me being out of work right then, to the drover I did say, "It's going out on the buffalo range depends upon your pay. But if you pay good wages, transportation to and fro, I think I might go with you to the trail of the buffalo." Of course I pay good wages and give transportation too, if you'll agree to work for me until the season's through. But if you do grow weary and you try and run away, you'll starve to death along the trail and also lose your pay. Well, with all this flattering talking, he signed up quite a train. Some 10 or 12 in number, some able-bodied men, and our trip was a pleasant one as we hit the westward road and crossed Old Boggy Creek in Old New Mexico. Well, there our pleasures ended and our troubles all began. A lightning storm did hit us and made our cattle run. I got all full of stickers from the cactus that did grow, and the outlaws waited to pick us off in the hills of Mexico. Well, the working season ended and the drover would not pay. "You all have drunk too much, you're all in debt to me." But the cowboys never had heard of such a thing as a bankrupt law, so we left that drover's bones to bleach on the trail of Buffalo.